this was a huge celebratory weekend, and I have a new film to talk to you about. I present to you Miss Juneteenth, and here is all Sugar has to say about that. Miss Juneteenth tells the story of Turquoise Jones, who is a former Miss Juneteenth pageant winner 15 years ago. She has won and has high expectations and great ambitions for the future, but we soon find out that the life of a beauty queen is not as glamorous as it may seem. Let me start by talking about the positives of this film. I enjoyed the performances from the lead, Turquoise Jones, who was played by Nicole Beharie. She did an exquisite job. She really took control of her character, and I liked following her. She was committed. She was really, really good. I enjoyed the daughter, Kai, played by Alexis Chakiz, who was making her film debut. She was also stunning. And I enjoyed the father, Ronnie, played by Kendrick Samson, who we know from Insecure and How to Get Away with Murder. His performance was really, really brilliant as well. Now, this film felt very surface. I liken this film to a well-prepared rack of ribs for those that like it. So you get the ribs in front of you and you're like, this smells good. Let me taste the sauce. You taste the sauce and then somebody comes and removes the plate from you. So all you get is the sauce. All you get is the surface. You didn't get a chance to get into the meat of this awesome meal. And that's how I would liken this film. This film felt very surface. It felt very restricted. I wanted to understand more about these characters. They were just touching on what the problems were. The film opens up, and in the first 10 minutes, we're learning about Turquoise Jones, and we see her holding on to her crown that she won about 15 years ago and her pageant dress. And all of the characters that we encounter in the first 10 minutes are talking about, oh, who could even imagine Miss Juneteenth would be here cleaning toilets and talking about all of the things that she failed to aspire to after becoming the prestigious Miss Juneteenth. Now, I had to watch the film for an hour and 10 minutes. See her going through. I don't understand why she's going through. We don't really know why she's still stuck in town. We got the overview of what's going on. We got a little bit of what Juneteenth meant. So you get a little sprinkle of the conflict, but you don't really get the real meat of what is going on, and you're left with many questions. Now, I will say on a positive that the performances from the lead characters did keep me connected through the film, but it still kept me longing for more. I had many questions and I needed to know what was going on, and I just did not receive the answers I was looking for. This film was written and directed by Shannon Godfrey Peoples. This was her directorial debut. I will say that the story was good. The script was okay, but I felt the direction was a little bit lackluster, and that is why we could not get the real meat. We got a little bit of the sauce, but I want the full meal. I want the full meat so that when I leave the table, when I leave the TV screen, I feel like, yes, this was well put together and I dined and my belly is full. I did not feel that with this film. Overall, this was an okay film. There were some good elements, and as I told you, the three performers that I quoted earlier, they really pushed the story forward and they really helped to fill in the gap. So even though somebody took away my meat, I was like, that sauce was still good. So they were the sauce. So I give her kudos for selecting such well-seasoned performance to tell this story. And then overall, it's all about the black movements, and this is a good black story, and we have some good black performers in the film, so it is worth your time. It is currently playing on video on demand, so you do have to pay for it, but I'd say go ahead and support, because all of these actors are telling a good story and they're doing a good job. So I say go on out and support this film. We're still celebrating black stories, so might as well celebrate by watching Miss Juneteenth. And that's about all Sugar has to say about that.